was in 1859 that John Brown led a little band of men against the arsenal at Harper's Ferry. John Brown's pitiful little army was crushed, and John Brown himself was captured. When the commanding officer, Colonel Robert E. Lee, asked John Brown what was his purpose, Brown replied, "My purpose, sir, is to free the slaves." "By whose authority?" asked Robert E. Lee. And John Brown answered, "By the authority of Almighty God." John Brown's body lies moldering in the grave. John Brown's body lies moldering in the grave. John Brown's body lies moldering in the grave. But his soul goes marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. And his soul goes marching on. John Brown died that the slaves might be free. John Brown died that the slaves might be free. John Brown died that the slaves might be free. And his soul goes marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His soul. Harper's Ferry, with his 19 men so true, he frightened old Virginia till she trembled through and through. They hung him for a traitor, themselves the traitor crew, but his soul goes marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. The army of the Lord, and his soul goes marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. And his soul. After John Brown was hanged, Julia Ward Howe sat in her hotel room in Washington, listening to the regiment sing John Brown's body as they marched to the front. From her windows, she could see the campfires of the Union Army, and as she watched them, a poem began to form in her mind. Trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He hath loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth. After Julia Ward Howe wrote the Battle Hymn of the Republic, Ralph Chaplin, a poet, artist and organizer for the industrial workers of the world, wrote Solidarity Forever. The idea had come to him while he was in West Virginia helping the coal miners during one of their great strikes. Chaplin said, "I wanted a song to be full of revolutionary fervor and to have a chorus that was singing and defiant." Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. For the union makes us strong. When the union's inspiration through the workers' blood shall run, there can be no power greater anywhere beneath the sun. Yet what force on earth is weaker than the feeble strength of one? But the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. For the union makes us strong. They have taken untold millions. They never toiled to earn. But without our brain and muscle, not a single wheel could turn. We can break their haughty power, gain our freedom when we learn that the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. For the union. Greater than their hoarded gold, greater than the might of armies, magnified a thousandfold. We can bring to birth a new world from the ashes of the old, for the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Thank you.